when I first started this program, I thought about doing something for children. I thought about, what could I do to help the disaster? What could I do? And then I thought, well, I could go clean up, but it's not helping that much. Because there's something deeper than just the outside image that we see. There's a deeper hurt deep down inside. The children have, some of the children in this community are in their teens, and they think that one day, and they hope that one day that they will be able to own the business that their parents and grandparents and great-grandparents have set forth for them. And to hear that they can no longer be able to share that success as their parents and grandparents did is something just breathtaking, because it's something that they've looked forward to in their life. So during their pain and their sorrow, I'm there. And when I wanted to do this program, I thought, where can I do it? Where can I do this, and how can I make it happen? And so when I found out that Small Wonders Childcare was doing an after-school program, I thought, what better way than to come in and help them? So I came in and I talked to their director. And then I asked her if there's something that I can do. And I told her what I wanted to do. And I established myself as a theater director here at Small Wonders Childcare. And I have helped these children become something else. Become what they thought, when they thought life was all over because they've lost everything, I helped them become better and see that they can be something. I have established relationships with directors of facilities in this area. I have made friendships with principals and teachers and leaders of small organizations in this community. I have met with several seafood industry owners and talked to them over the phone and let them know that I am there for them, that I am there to help them and to better them. I have talked with parents. I have made very long-term relationships with parents and students. And I have made friendships that will help me when I reach out, when I go to help the children, when I go to teach the children. I have made friendships that will come back at me and that will also help me. The way I've made this aware to the community is that I've made phone calls and went around to businesses and let them know what I was doing for them, let them know that there is someone out there that's trying to reach out their hand and make something better. And not only have I reached out to the children, but I'm also talking to the parents and getting on their level and let them know, you know, what their children aren't telling them, that they're telling me and letting them know. I have extended out flyers and phone calls, and I've had people just put it all over the internet about what I'm doing for others. I have teamed up with Project Rebound, Alta Point, and Project 166, and told them what it is that I was doing. And they are helping me get the word out. A lot of organizations are reaching small children, like small groups of children. But instead of just going into something little and maybe affecting the lives of 10 or 15 children, I've stepped out of that and I've went into not only affecting one area school, but taking it to Small Wonders Childcare, where they house 6 and 7 different schools in this community. And I've said that instead of going to St. Elmo Elementary School, I'm going to go to Small Wonders, where we do St. Elmo, Grand Bay Middle, and many others. And that's how I have, and that is why I think that I have done an extensive work and gone further than others have. Because of the BP oil spill and the lack of counseling in our community, I came together and I said, you know what? Let me not only bring arts and theater to the table, but let me bring a mentoring and a counseling and just someone that the kids can just sit down and talk to. Somebody that they can get things off of their chest. This award means so much to me. If you allow me to do something with you and to get this award, I will not just keep it housed in something little. I will make it big. I will not just show my community, but I will extend it out and branch it out to where other communities will hear and learn and see that we're not only doing this for the community, but to bring a better nation. I think I deserve this award because I want to change the world, change this community. And it takes little steps at a time. With this community and these children, I have helped over 100 children. And these children are taking it from themselves and going out and helping others. These children are the ones that we're going to see when they get older being in nonprofit organizations and big brothers, big sisters. These are the children that we're going to see on the side of the road picking up trash just because. These children are the ones that we need to get to, the ones that we need to focus. There were many obstacles I faced. I had to pretty much take it all on myself. When we did a play, I made the costumes. I had other help with me, but I had to go out and get that help and bring it to me. I had to make the costumes, to set up the props, to make everything happen and work, and just fit in a connection and just run smoothly. There were many times where I just wanted to pretty much give it up. But then, the little inspirations that came in my life, the smallest victims of the big people, the children, they were my inspiration. When I saw smiles on their face and their laughter, it was just an overwhelming joy. And I saw that this community that was once in its prime had fallen. These children weren't smiling. They weren't happy about it. When they go home and their parents are crying on the couch because they can't afford their bills, they see that and reflects them. When they go home and they hear their parents fighting because one or the other can't find a job and they don't know what else to do but to fight about it. He walked up to me with his hand behind his back and he said, "Mr. Kyle, I was in the store the other day with my mom and she couldn't afford a purse. She wanted one so bad she wanted a new purse, and she didn't have money for it." Then he looked at me and he said, pulled out the purse from behind his back, one that we had just got, and he said, "Chicago, can I give this one to my mom? Just show her how much I love her, how much I care for her." Said, "Bud, you take that home to your mom and you give it to her and you tell her that you love her." That's the little things that I'm helping these kids to achieve. That's the little things that matter. Those little moments when they come up to me and they ask me things like that, or that I see that they are improving themselves, that they are caring about others because I care for them. With your help, I would like to bring this better tomorrow to them. And I would like to show them that they are not alone in this battle. And that I will always be there to help them through any of their troubles. Together, I would like to do something.